In this video, I'll show you how easy it is to connect a hard drive to a Z80 processor. All we need is the super simple Z80 computer on perf board that I already described in previous videos, a bunch of jumper wires and some 74 LS00 NAND gates for glue logic. The whole thing consists mainly of a Z80 CPU, some kilobytes of RAM, a serial communication chip and an Arduino Mega. Everything tinkered together so it can run CPM and all historical programs that were made for this operating system many years ago. Watch the video that I linked here if you want to know more about CPM and how to run it on that computer. In the video description you can also find links to my previous videos on how this thing works in detail. The hard disk I'm using here is a 40 GB putter drive from an old laptop. Only hard drives with that typical 14-pin connector are possible here. The older MFM or recent SATA drives require additional controllers and are therefore not so easy to connect. That's why I went for the easy-to-use putter drives and the easy-to-use protocol, which I talked about in one of my previous videos. Like the Z80 itself, Putter uses 5V TTL levels, parallel data transfer, and the drives are still available on eBay or can be salvaged from old computers. With an inexpensive adapter, compact flash cards from older digital cameras can also be used as Putter drives. Let's take a quick look at the schematic. 8 of the 16 data pins are directly connected to the Z80 data bus. If an 8-bit mode is available for the drive in use, we can turn it on via software. If there is no such mode, the other 8 bits are simply ignored, with the result that only half of the storage capacity is available. However, this is not a problem at all, since the CPM and associated programs only require a few kilobytes of memory. Next, we need to connect the three address lines A0 through A2 to gain access to the drive's registers and of course the read and write strobe lines. The hard drive is either activated or switched to high impedance by a small logic circuit that combines the Z80 I/O request signal with the address pin A5 so that the putter registers can be accessed starting from I/O address 20 hex. The last thing that we need to do is to implement the read and write routine in the CPM BIOS. There we read and write the sectors byte by byte from and to the data registers of the drive. To turn the thing on, I connect it to my LabBench power supply and connect it to the USB port on my PC via the USB serial converter. Then I start CPM using the serial hard drive emulation explained in my last video. The files that are physically on my PC are displayed on drive A now. And the hard drive will show up as empty drive B. We can copy the files from A to B using the pip command, as was common in the CPM era. In contrast to DOS, CPM does not support file folders. However, files can be organized in up to 16 so-called user areas. By entering the user code of an area followed by the drive letter and a colon, we can access the files that belong to a certain area. I have some games under the user area 3, so I can now start them directly from the hard drive. And they load surprisingly quickly compared to the time it takes to start from the emulated A drive. Right now, I'm happy with the way it works. But there is one more thing that I like to improve. We still need the Arduino and the hard drive emulation tool to start CPM. My goal is to get this computer to run on its own without the need for an Arduino and PC. So I have to write a bootloader that initializes the hard drive and loads CPM from there into memory. And I'd want to permanently save this on the static RAM instead of any kind of ROM. This is where the lithium cell will come into play. In future videos, I will show you how I improve this gadget step by step and also other interesting experiments around the Z80 and CPM. So you can look forward to more videos on this topic. If you like this video, click the like button to help this channel grow. Check out my other videos, and if you enjoyed them too, consider to subscribe to my channel and turn on notifications, so you will always be informed on what I'm doing. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye.